Shri Krishna marries Jaambavati and Satyabhaamaa. Satrajit was a resident of Dwaraka and a great devotee of the sun god. He performed great tapas in praise of the sun god, for which the god was much pleased and presented Satrajit with a gem called Shyamantakam. The gem had as much luster as the sun god, and further, when it was properly installed and worshipped, it would yield about 50 mounts of gold every day. Thus, it was able to ward off all famines and pestilences in its vicinity. Satrajit was very proud of it and hung it round his neck whenever he travelled. One day he was coming to Dwaraka. People saw him and thought that the sun god himself had descended to earth and was coming. They reported the news to Sri Krishna. He enlightened them and explained that it was only Satrajit wearing the gem and not the sun. At one time, Sri Krishna hinted through well-wishers that such a great gem must be the property of the king and that it might be presented to Ugrasena, the king of Dwaraka. Satrajit would not agree. Time passed on. One day, Prasena, brother of Satrajit, put on the gem round his neck and went to the forest for a hunt. He was killed there by a lion. The lion was killed by a bear called Jaambavan. Jaambavan took the gem home and decorated it on his child's cradle. As Prasena did not turn up in due time, Satrajit presumed that for the sake of the gem, Sri Krishna had killed his brother, and so began to mourn the loss. Slowly, the strange news reached the ears of Sri Krishna, who, being innocent, could not bear it. He regretted the fault of having once asked for the gem to be given to the king. He decided to prove his innocence. He went to the forest, saw the dead body of Prasena, the dead body of the lion which killed him, and also the footprints of the fight that took place between the lion and a bear. He traced the footprints of the bear and reached a cave. He asked his followers to wait at the entrance of the cave and went in, promising to return soon. The followers waited there for 12 days. There was no sign of Sri Krishna's coming back. They took him for dead, returned to the city and declared so in Dwaraka. Sri Krishna went into the cave, saw the gem hanging on a cradle. The baby in the cradle, seeing a stranger, cried out. Jaambavan came out and gave battle to Sri Krishna. 28 days they fought. There was no end. Jaambavan then realized that the other was no other than the Supreme Lord. He fell at his feet, begged for pardon, and in repentance, he gave his daughter Jaambavati to him as wife and also the gem. Sri Krishna returned to the city with the bride and the gem, called in Satrajit to the darbar and handed over the gem to him. Satrajit was half dead with shame for falsely accusing the Lord. He made amends by giving his daughter Satyabhaamaa and also the gem to Krishna. Sri Krishna accepted Satyabhaamaa but returned the gem and said that Satrajit, being a devotee of the sun god, deserved it.